When we use turbulence models, the transport equations for those models require boundary conditions, and inlet boundary conditions can have an impact on the results, so it's useful to talk about how we set those values. When a turbulent flow enters the computational domain at inlets, or at outlets in the case that you have backflow, then boundary conditions are required for K, epsilon, omega, the Reynolds stresses, depending on which of the turbulence models that you selected. In Fluent, you have four methods available to either directly or indirectly specify the boundary conditions for these. The values can be input explicitly, and this is the only method that allows for profile definition, so if you wanted to use a non-uniform profile, this would be the method that you would use. However, there is a problem with this, because although the turbulent kinetic energy is relatively physically intuitive, variables like epsilon or omega are not very intuitive, and they're difficult or even impossible to measure. So the other options that Fluent provides allow you to define the boundary conditions in terms of more intuitive physical parameters, and then behind the scenes, Fluent will take the physical parameters and translate those into specific values for the non-intuitive variables. So all of these methods use the turbulent intensity. And then, depending on what you know about the flow, you can choose one of the three available methods. One method you prescribe the turbulent length scale, and the length scale is related to the size of the large eddies in the flow that contain most of the turbulent kinetic energies. If you have a boundary layer flow, this could be about 40% of the boundary layer thickness. If the inlet is downstream of a grid, then the length scale would be proportional to the size of the opening. If you're dealing with an internal flow, then the hydraulic diameter is a particularly convenient parameter to be able to enter. And in other cases, you can specify the turbulent intensity and the turbulent viscosity ratio. This is mainly used in external flows, but also in some cases where you're not really sure. So the default setting for this value is that the turbulent intensity is 5%. And the turbulent viscosity ratio is 10, and these are reasonable values for many flows in case you don't have more precise information available to you. Sometimes you can run into a case where it's challenging to choose the inlet values for the turbulence. In that case, if you have absolutely no idea, there's a few guidelines that you can use to choose the settings. Normally in turbulent flows, turbulent intensities range from about 1% to about 5%. Anything larger than about 5% is highly turbulent. The default turbulent intensity value of 5% is probably sufficient for nominal turbulence through a circular inlet, and it's a good estimate that you can use if experimental data is not available. For external flows, it's common to use a turbulent viscosity ratio of 1 to 10, and for internal flows, the turbulent viscosity ratio is commonly in a range of 10 to 100. An example of this, you can calculate a fully developed pipe flow at a Reynolds number of 50,000, and you can see that the bulk turbulent viscosity ratio is around 100. It's important to note here, or useful to note anyways, in cases where you're really not sure about these values, it's good practice to perform a sensitivity study on your solution and see how sensitive it is to the values that you've selected.